Welcome to the MIND Project's Virtual Stroke Lab. There are two versions of this lab. This video version was created because the original lab is an interactive Flash program and browsers stopped supporting Flash at the end of 2020. However, if you are willing to download the lab onto your computer and run it in a special Flash window, the original interactive version of the lab is still available to you. You'll find it at the address below, together with supporting materials for this video version. We now begin the video version of the Virtual Stroke Lab. Welcome to the MIND Project's Virtual Stroke Lab. This is a video version of what was originally a Flash program with interactivity like a video game. While the choices in the lab are now made by those of us creating this video, your overall experience will be remarkably similar. It's best to take the first-person perspective and imagine you are making all of the choices. Don't passively watch the video. To master the content and to learn all of the medical procedures and data gathering methods, you must pay careful attention to everything that happens, reading every word of text, exploring everything on the screen, and making sure that you always understand what is happening and why it is happening. If you do, your experience will be similar to doing the original lab, and most important, what you learn will be exactly the same. There are no pauses in the video to give you time to read the text on screen. That is by design. You must hit the pause button yourself each time something new appears on the screen to give yourself time to read the text or examine the images. This video will take several times longer than its running time to complete. Good luck and enjoy. You are now accessing the EMR, the electronic medical record. Much of the medical training you need to diagnose and treat the stroke patient is found in the EMR. Those entries exist as a PDF file that you can download here. Or each EMR entry also appears briefly in this video. If you prefer to read it in the video instead of on the PDF, then pause the video at each new screen so there's time to read it. Don't skip this information.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.